Hello again, everyone. Welcome back to Ultima 7. All right, let's talk to Lord British. Hey, stop moving. You see your old friend Lord British, looking a bit older than when you last saw him. His eyes gleam at the sight of you.
Welcome, my friend, he says, embracing you. Please, tell me what brings thee to Britannia.
Well, you know, I got bored with the dinosaurs and the Martians, and, your alter egos there, you know, Sherman and Garrett and stuff like that, they just weren't you.
Oh, more importantly, what brought thee here?
Name. Lord British laughs.
What, art thou joking, Avatar? Dost thou not recognize thine old friend?
Name!
Job.
Lord British rolls his eyes.
Must we go through this formality? He laughs, shaking his head. Very well. As thou well knowest, I am sovereign of Britannia and have been for some time now. Even though I come from thine homeland, I have chosen to live my life here.
Tell me about the rumble.
Lord British looks at you gravely. The foundation of Britannia was shaken with the rising of an island. This event was no random disaster. It was one of sorcerous intent.
Indeed. Okay. Tell me about the Fellowship. We'll jump around subjects here.
They're an extremely useful and productive group of citizens. Thou shouldst most certainly visit the Fellowship headquarters here in Britain and speak with Batlin. The Fellowship has done many good deeds throughout Britannia.
You know what? Actually, I should probably try to emulate the voice used at the beginning of Ultima 7, Part 2, Serpent Isle.
The Fellowship has done many good deeds throughout Britannia, including feeding the poor, educating and helping those in need, and promoting general goodwill and peace.
Orb of the Moons.
Mine has not worked since the troubles with magic began. In fact, none of the moon gates have been working reliably for quite a while. Didst thou bring thine Orb of the Moons?
No. I see.
Thou might be stranded in Britannia. Here, why not try mine? I shall let thee borrow it. Perhaps it will work for thee. Be careful, though. The moon gates have become dangerous.
Lord British hands you his Orb of the Moons. A red moon gate brought me here, actually. You relate the story of how a red moon gate appeared behind your house and mysteriously took you to Trinsic. Lord British's brow creases as you speak. Finally, he says,
I did not send the red moon gate to fetch thee. Someone or something must have activated that moon gate.
Wonder if it was the Guardian.
And that is strange indeed, because we have been having a bit of trouble with moon gates as of late. In fact, we have been having trouble with magic in general.
Tell me about Britannia.
The state of the land could not be more prosperous. Dost thou realize that thou hast been away for 200 Britannian years?
Yeah, Iolo told me. Lord British wags a finger at you.
I am certain that thy friends have rued thine absence. 'Tis a shame thou didst stay away so long.
Hey, it's not like I have much control over coming and going here.
But I am very happy to see thee. Britannia is prosperous and abundant. Look around thee. Explore the newly refurbished castle. Travel the land. Peace is prominent in all quarters. Yes, Britannia has never been better. Well, almost never.
Almost never?
Well, things are indeed fine. It is the people I am concerned about. There's something wrong in Britannia, but I do not know what it is. Something is hanging over the heads of the Britannian people. They're unhappy. One can see it in their eyes. There's nothing that is unifying the population, since there has been peace for so long. Perhaps thou couldst determine what is happening. I implore thee to go out amongst the people. Watch them in their daily tasks. Speak with them. Work with them. Break bread with them. Perhaps they need someone like the Avatar to take an interest in their lives.
Tell me about our homeland.
I know it has been many a year since I visited our Earth. But surely thou dost remember that the two of us hail from the same time and place. And as brothers in origin...
Hey, I'm not your brother.
Thou shouldst also remember that thou canst ask me for aid at any time thou mightest require it.
Tell me about this island.
Yes, Almendretta, I felt a great disturbance in the ether when this island rose from the sea. The island is none other than the Isle of Fire, where thou defeated the Hellspawn Exodus.
Ah, hey. Well, hopefully there isn't a Earth Serpent guarding the entrance to it this time. Tell me about Batlin.
He is a druid who began the fellowship about 20 years ago. He is highly intelligent and is a warm and gentle human being.
Yeah, you're not a very good judge of person, are you? Tell me about the headquarters.
Yes, it is not far from the castle, to the southwest. It is just south of the theater.
A theater, huh? Tell me about the moon gates.
The moon gates are not functioning. We cannot use them as we have in the past. Not only are they dysfunctional, they are, in fact, dangerous. One of my trusted sages used mine own Orb of the Moons to travel to the Shrine of Humility, and his body did shatter upon entering the gate. If only that mage in Cove hadn't gone mad.
What's wrong with the magic?
Something is awry. Magic has not been working for the longest time. I even have trouble creating food with magic. It must be something to do with the magical ether. There are those who say that magic is dying, what with the trouble with the moon gates and the situation with Nystal. I am beginning to suspect that they might be right.
Lord British studies you a moment.
Perhaps the magic will work much better for thee. Thou hast not been in Britannia long. It is possible that whatever has affected magic has not made its mark upon thee yet. Please try it. A spellbook is stored with the rest of thine equipment.
Hey, excellent. Equipment. I need this.
Thou art welcome to any of mine equipment. I keep it in a locked storeroom here in the castle. Thou wilt find the key in my study.
Oh, I will be going there then. Tell me about your study.
'Tis in the western end of the castle.
And storeroom?
I am sure thou canst find it.
The ruler smiles slyly.
Consider it something of a game.
Spellbook.
Yes, I have a spellbook stored away with the rest of the equipment.
What can you tell us about our old friends?
That must mean Iolo, Shimino, and Dupre, of course.
Yes, I do. Tell me about the castle.
Yes, it has been redecorated since thy last visit. The architects and workers did a splendid job.
The ruler leans toward you with a sour look on his face.
The only mar in the entire complex is that damn nursery.
Tell me about the aid.
Do not forget, Avatar, that I have the power to heal thee. That is one bit of magic that still seems to work for me. And I could probably provide thee with some equipment and a spellbook.
Let's just get those gone. All right. Tell me about the Isle of Fire.
Elmendretta, thou shouldst know that when I created the Shrines of the Virtues, I also set upon this island 3 great shrines dedicated to the principles of truth, love, and courage. They reside within the walls of the Castle of Fire. I never revealed this to thee before, as I thought them forever lost when the Isle of Fire mysteriously sank beneath the waves. The shrines are meant for the use of an avatar only, and therefore a talisman will be necessary to use one. The talismans are guarded by tests that thou shouldst have no problem passing if thou wishest to seek their counsel.
Their counsel? I can't believe you misspelled their, British.
If thou wishest to seek out this isle, thou mayest use my ship. It now sits upon the southern shore of Vesper, and is called the Golden Ankh. Please, feel free to use it, for as long as thou hast need of it.
Hey, free ship! That'll save me some cash. Lord British hands you the deed to the ship, but it slips from your hands and falls to the floor.
I have also focused a magical crystal to the entrance of the castle. To the entrance of the Castle of Fire, which I refurbished after thy battle with Exodus. Here, take it. Perhaps it will give thee some insight. Although be warned, it is not at all stable and might be prone to shatter the nearer thou findest thyself to the location to which it is tuned.
Lord British gives you the crystal, and once again your overloaded condition makes you clumsy. Luckily, it remains intact after its little fall. tell me about Exodus.
Thy battle with that strange mixture of machine and spirit is now legendary. Do be careful if thou art going to the Isle, for the remains of that being now reside in one of the chambers of the Castle of Fire.
Tell me about the Mad Mage. The ruler leans forward and speaks quietly.
There's a Mad Mage in Cove by the name of Rudium. Dost thou remember him? Rudium was working with a magical substance called Blackrock. Before he went mad, he claimed that this mineral could solve the problems of the moon gates. I suggest that thou shouldst go to Cove and find him. Try to learn what it was he was doing with this Blackrock material. It could be our only hope.
I thought Obi-Wan was our only hope.
Tell us about Cove. Surely thou dost remember Cove. It is a very pleasant town to the east of Britain, quite relaxing.
Tell me about Nystal.
Try talking to him.
Okay. Tell me about Aello.
I have seen our old friend rarely over the years. I understand he has been spending most of his time intrinsic. Hello, Aello, how art thou?
I am well, my liege. 'Tis good to see thee.
Tell me about Shimino.
That rascal does not come around very often, though I understand he spends most of his time in Britain these days.
That's pretty rude. Tell me about Dupre.
I have not seen that one since I knighted him. Typical. I do the man a favor and he disappears. I heard he might be in Jellum.
Tell me about the nursery.
I will not go near the place. Kings and dirty diapers do not mix. The great council talked me into implementing the nursery after several of my staff started having families. Although it was probably a necessity, I shall pretend it does not exist.
Tell me about Rudyum.
He was a brilliant and respected mage, but something happened to him in recent years. He seems to be He seemed to go completely senile.
Tell me about Trinsic.
I have not been down there in many years. Has something happened there?
Nothing much. A murder.
Murder? Intrinsic? The ruler looks concerned. I've heard nothing about it. Art thou investigating it?
Yep.
Very good. It pleases me that thou art concerned about my people. After all, it's not like I am.
The king pauses a moment.
Now that thou dost mention it, I have had reports of other similar murders in the past few months. In fact, there was one here in Britain 3 or 4 years ago. The body was mutilated in a ritualistic fashion. Apparently there is a maddened killer on the loose, but I have no doubt that someone such as thee, Avatar, can find him.
Why haven't you done something to find him? Tell me about Jellum.
A rather violent place, by all accounts. I have not had the pleasure of visit in quite a while.
Ritualistic?
I do not recall many details. Thou shouldst ask Patterson, the town mayor, about it. He may remember more.
Tell me about the killer.
That is, of course, only an assumption on my part, but that is all we have to work with. Unless thou hast already uncovered some useful information?
Hook.
A man with a hook? The king rubs his chin. No, I do not recall ever meeting a man with a hook.
I'm not surprised. It's not like you've been out of the castle much. Crown Jewel.
I am afraid I cannot possibly know of every ship that comes through our ports.
Fired! You're fired! I'm setting myself up as queen.
Thou shouldst check with Clint the shipwright, if thou hast not done so.
No, I kind of came straight here.
Goodbye. Goodbye, Elmendretta. Do come back soon.
Alright, so, got some stuff. Game really wouldn't let me pick up. Let's see if we can move those coins to... Nope, too heavy. Okay. Alright. Well, for now, let's put the money in here. And... let's go ahead and put this deed in here and our gem in there. Let's take a look at the gem. Great. That's fantastic. That's very interesting. Lovely. Okay. All right. Well, British did mention some stuff. The throne room of Lord British. Hi, guys. Spark! How dare you sit down on the throne, Spark? It's my throne. Now I am queen! Alright. There's a secret door there. Alright, can't open it right now. Alright, well, first of all, let's head into British's bedroom. Key to the Black Gate. The pages bound within this book contain well-documented clue information from the invaluable sources at Origin Systems. Lord British, the biography of Britannia's longtime ruler, by K. Benos. While many may remember that Lord British was once but one of 8 monarchs back when the lands were known as Caesarea,
Few are aware that he is not even a native of our own lovely Britannia. His origin is from another world, one from which he entered ours by way of a red moon gate. In fact, it is through this same type of gate that the Avatar of Legend purportedly enters Britannia. As ruler of one... I've used a blue moon gate before. As ruler of one of the eight kingdoms, he was instrumental in selecting a champion to face mundane Minex and Exodus. When the terrible machine Exodus was defeated, 'twas Lord British behind whom all the people of Susaria rallied. The unified land became known as Britannia, with Lord British as the sole monarch. He was kind of known... he was the only king, even when... He was king, the sole king before Exodus was defeated, too, you know, game. Whatever. Though never let it be said that he rules with a tyrannical hand, his reign has always been one of truth, love, and courage, supported by his utmost belief in the eight virtues. It was Lord British who had the insight to call forth a quest for the Avatar, whom also happened to be the champion from the days of Sosaria, and who gave prosperity and happiness unto the people. Then came his mysterious disappearance, when the stranger who became the Avatar was called by his companions to aid in the search for the lost monarch. Note how Lord Blackthorn, affected by the Shadow Lords, quickly turned Britannia's fair lands into a place of terror. But find our noble lord, the Avatar did, and Britannia was restored its former peaceful state. Then came the Gargoyles, and our honorable sovereign thoughtfully requested the return of the Avatar. That wasn't quite how it happened at the end, but whatever. I've got another book here. Everything an Avatar Should Know About Sex. Wait a second. It's empty. Boo. Oh my, that is some tapestry in the Lord British's private room here. Let's go ahead and open that. There's nothing in there. Is this going to close it? That is going to close it. All right. Let's go ahead and open it then. Open that. Hey there, British. Can we go this way? That is open. Good. Let's just go ahead and open everything. Woohoo! Not much of interest there. There are a lot of secret passages here. Let's just open them all up. Because we can. Why not? Alright, there's stairs up. That, we found the way, so we don't need to, now we just need the key. That's what we need now. What is this gonna open? That opens that, okay. What is this one? Okay, interesting. Well, I suppose if you're coming down the stairs, you'd want that. Why is there a powder keg in there? Well, let's take the cake. Let's see, there's a jar. Jar. Whistle. Let's go ahead and take that. Spark, you hold on to that. That is really weird. Isn't that awesome? I know you like that, Spark. I bet you do. I know you have to like that. You better like it. Like it! 101 ways to treat the cheat at NIM by Dr. Cat. Within the pages of this tome are all the many ways to earn supplementary gold by gambling at NIM, written by the originator of the game himself. This book covers in depth such strategy as claw first, question later, and there are no ways to skin a cat. Interesting. Mempto rays, a qualitative study in metaparaphilosophical radiation by Mempto.
Despite Falcrodan's theory of 0335, there are indeed rays of energy that constantly bombard Britannia. In fact, these very same rays permeate all the known space between Britannia and the stars. Recent experiments have proven my theory that these rays, known hereafter as Mempto rays, are lethal to all non-living matter. In fact, Mempto rays have demonstrated their ability numerous times, once killing an entire boulder in a matter of a few hours. It is my recommendation... Killing a boulder in a matter of a few hours. Vargas's stories of legend. Reasons why one should never build doors facing north or west. Many centuries ago, the prophet Father Entos foretold the coming of a plague of locusts that would arrive from the lands to the north. He predicted that their source area was so important that it would indicate who would survive the attack and who would not. He predicted that anyone living in a house having a door to the, with a northern exposure would perish under the onslaught. 2 days later, the locusts came, and in the aftermath, it was discovered that only the houses with doors on the north wall were destroyed. The naturalist Ergan incorporated Algoth's discovery that the sun rises from the east, theorizing that the nightly path of many dark-dwelling nasties could be traced. As the sun moves slowly to the west, Ergan contends, shadows increase in the east, forcing monsters to move that direction to stay out of the sun. Therefore, as denizens of the dark travel from the west, they are more likely to invade households with doors that directly cross their paths. That's because of the isometric view in the game. If a building had a door here or here and not here or here on the outside, then you'd never be able to get into them. Ooh, hey, a key. Is that the key that I wanted? I bet it is. Let's go ahead and put this into our key bag. Got a couple more books. The Day It Didn't Work by R. Allen G. This collection of essays details the difficulties in overseeing a group of well-meaning misfits in a mechanical environment, especially when the overseer is a misfit as well. No One Leaves by R. Allen G. The sequel to The Day It Didn't Work. This short tome offers insight to why new mechanical contraptions don't always function at the time agreed upon between mechanician and overseer, despite how constructed they may appear. In addition, the work discusses how to handle presenting the complaints to the tinkerers who worked on them, and how to persuade them to finish the work regardless of how tired they are and how late in the evening it is. And no one leaves. No Way to Jump by Desmond. Herein lies a compilation that discusses various elements found in adventure stories. In addition to an evaluation of their literary worth, one essay demonstrates how to apply such elements in other styles. Up Is Out by Goodfellow. Herein is discussed the most current theories on gravity and mass. After years of study and research, the author finally put the fruits of his labor down on the pages of this tome, which includes his discussion of falling apples. How to Conquer the World in 3 Easy Steps by Maximilian the Amazingly Mean. Found within are the ravings of a deranged megalomaniac cleric describing his plans for the domination of Britannia. And after I have acquired the vast corpse spell, there will be no one to defy me, for all will fear my casting of the spell. Even the aloft Lord Brit himself will offer his obeisance to me.
Maybe...
And read this book. What a Fool Believes by P. Nolan. Within the pages of this book is a story of a bard, a blonde, and a bottle. The perfect combination for a classic tale of the war between the sexes. If you say so. There's a little bit of food there. There's an oil lamp. 5 Stages of Lawn Care by A.P. Burke. This is the brilliant and witty depiction of the humorous antics of 2 young boys during one very hot summer in Britannia. From courting to practicing swordplay, the duo never seems to be able to avoid trouble. Though the boys grow up by the end of the story, they don't quite seem to lose all of their youthful instinct. That need not be on? What are you talking about, lady? Of course it need be on. Trophy. Alright, well let's head up here. Hey, who are you? Peasant, you see a thoroughly disheartened young man who is miserably languishing behind bars. Name?
I am Weston.
What's your job?
I have none so long as I am left to rot here in this prison.
My job is to pay for the crime thou hast committed.
What can you tell me about prison?
My crime was stealing apples from the royal orchards. This I did, and I admit it freely. If given the same set of circumstances, I would do it again.
Ha ha! Not only an unrepentant criminal, but also a potential professional thief! Looks like this one has ended in the right place and just in the nick of time.
Stealing apples?
I had offered to buy them first, but Fig, the caretaker of the orchard, set an exorbitant price which I am certain he would have pocketed for himself. So yes, I admit to stealing them.
See how the common criminal blames his type of immoral behavior on others, all the while denying it in himself. This one is irredeemable, he is.
What circumstances are these?
I am not from Britain, m'lady. I am from Paws, and it is another reason why they believe it I can be trifled with.
This prisoner is from Paws. I bloody knew it. To his credit, he was in town nearly an entire day before he stole something. For a citizen of Paws, that is as honest as they come.
Wow, that's pretty bad. You're pretty prejudiced there, guard. What can you tell me about Fig?
He gives baskets of fruit free to the fellowship without Lord British's consent, I am quite certain.
Thou shouldst not listen to this obvious slander, m'lady. It is hearsay.
You admit it?
Mine only regrets are that I did not try to steal something bigger, and that I did not get away with it.
Tell me about Paws.
Paws is a town where thou mayest feel the icy grip of poverty about thine heart.
Oh, bloody hell! Now I suppose he is going to go and tell us his whole pathetic life story. Couldst thou wait until I get out mine handkerchief so I do not interrupt thee with all my wailing?
Tell me about the town.
Not so long ago, Paws was a thriving rustic coastal village, but as Britain grew larger, most of the local businesses moved there. We became a farming town, and the 7-year drought gave us a lashing that we have yet to recover from.
Well, tell me about the poverty.
I do not wish to bemoan my fate, but my family lives in Paws, my wife Alina and my child Cassie. They were starving, and I came to Britain to get food for them.
Oh, now, do not go and bring up poverty as an excuse as to why thou hast turned to crime. My father was so poor, he and his family had to eat dirt, but he still raised me proper.
Excuse me.
Beat the stuffing out of me if he ever so much as imagined I did anything wrong. I can tell thee that.
Well, that sure does explain a lot, Mr. Guard. Tell me about your family.
I do not want any mercy for myself. I have admitted my guilt, but my life does not only belong to myself. It belongs to my wife and family as well. Without me, they will suffer unbearable hardships such as they might not survive.
Excuse me. Starving?
Although there are fools who will speak otherwise, the people of Britannia are being crushed by the vicious tyranny of the class system. While a few have more than they could ever enjoy, there are many who go to sleep hungry every night. My wife and daughter, to name two of them.
Oh, that reminds me. It is nearly time for my meal break. The trout is supposed to be delicious today at the farmer's market.
Fools? Fools like our good friend the guard would have us believe that nothing has changed in Britannia over 200 years.
That we can live our lives as if all our problems do not exist. I say to thee that it is people like that who cause our problems in the first place.
I can't disagree with that, that's for sure. Tell me about the class system.
Well, I am certain Lord British is a just and fair ruler. He must be quite unaware of all that goes on in his kingdom. Surely he would not tolerate such inequity.
All right, that is enough noise out of thee. All day long, yakada yakada about the awful, terrible class system. Why, the next thing thou knowest thou shalt be saying society is to blame for thy crimes. Not a word from anybody about any appreciation for keeping the laws in order. No, of course not. But all the pity in the world for the dangerous lawbreakers who are the real threat to society.
Wouldst thou speak with Lord British about me? I would bet that he is completely unaware of my case. Please, wilt thou speak with him?
Yes, I will.
Oh, I thank thee, Avatar. My fate and the fates of my wife and daughter are in thine hands.
Alright, goodbye.
I thank thee for visiting me.
You see a tough-looking palace guard who takes his job very seriously.
Name. I am a guard.
So your name is a guard? Okay, Mr. Guard. What's your job? Man looks at you like you are an ignoramus. I'm a guard for the palace, idiot! Thou shouldst go about thy business. I should totally have you fired. Goodbye. Good day, sir! Man, what a jerk. Now, let's check these other towers as long as I'm up here. Ooh! Ooh! I see stuff. I see stuff! Spellbook! Yes! Ooh! Awaken, weather, douse, fireworks, glimmer, help, ignite, thunder. Cure and light, first circle. Fire blast in second circle. Heal in the third circle. And now everything is empty. Dang it. It is going to cost me a lot of money to get all these spells. I can tell you that much. Okay, excellent. That's money. You know, I need more people in my party. I really need more people in my party. Ooh, I like that. Screw those boots. Magic boots. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Magic boots. Magic boots. Magic boots. Some money. 25 gold coins. We'll get that a little later. Some food. We've got a bedroll, which we need, but for now, we really need more people in our party, because can't really pick up all that much stuff right now. There are a couple people that we can get in town, so I think we will do that shortly. Plate armor? Musket? There must be a way in here somewhere. I'll have to look around for that. And there's nothing in there. All right, let's see if we can go talk to Lord British. Hi, Mr. Gargoyle. I'm ignoring you for now. Weston. Lord British listens to your story about Weston. He looks concerned. I do not recall this case. Let me check. He quickly scans a large scroll. Imprisoned for the theft of one apple from the royal orchards. Ludicrous! Someone must have usurped mine authority. Thou mayst consider this man pardoned. An investigation will commence immediately into the circumstances surrounding his arrest, and into this fellow Fig. My thanks to thee, Avatar. Maybe you should pay more attention from now on? Just saying. Alright, now, first of all, there is definitely a lever somewhere that I want to look for. I don't remember exactly where it is, and I might have to, check the fact to see exactly where it is rather than stare at the map looking for it. But I'll check a couple of the places that I think might be kind of obvious. Actually, aha, there it is. Alrighty. So we can pretty much take everything in this castle without anyone complaining about it, so we're pretty good there. Let's see. Is it open? It is. Ha ha ha! Okay. Screw that. Screw that. Screw that. Alright, plate leggings. Plate armor. A gorget. A great helm. Won't I'm going to try to put it in the bag. He's trying to equip it. There we go. Quaris, now I'm overloaded. Let's ditch that. Can I take that shield? Nope, too heavy. Alright, well, we'll have to get that later then, I think. Alright, well, in the next episode, we will go get a few more people in our party. A couple more people, really. That way we can just dump stuff on them. Alright, we'll see you all in the next episode.